Hi students, good morning to all. Hope all of you are fine. Let me introduce myself. I am Sindhu, handling the subject biology. Okay, so let us discuss the third chapter in biology, that is chemical messages for homeostasis. And I think all of you know about homeostasis. What is homeostasis? It is a process by which the internal equilibrium is maintaining in the body. And in the first two chapters, we already discussed about how does the responses are happens in the human body. And I think all of you know that it is by the action of nervous system. Okay? Then it is not only by the action of the nervous system, it is by the combined effort of both nervous system and endocrine system. Okay, so the responses are happens in the human body by the combined effort of both nervous system and endocrine system. And endocrine system consists a group of glands responsible for producing a group of secretions. And these secretions were termed as hormones. These secretions were termed as hormones. And hormones are considered as the chemical messengers for conveying the message in between the organs. Okay, so anyway, in this chapter, we are going to make a discussion about the endocrine glands and the hormone produced by the endocrine glands and how does these hormones are responsible for regulating our body activities. Okay, so today we are going to make a discussion about the endocrine gland, that is pancreas. And I think all of you heard about pancreas, because pancreas is the digestive gland that you already studied in the last year in the digestive system. So what is the speciality of pancreas? No, it is both endocrine and exocrine. Exocrine means it acts as a digestive gland and responsible for producing the digestive juices, which is responsible for break down the complex organic food items into simpler molecules. Okay. At the same time, it acts as an endocrine gland too by producing the hormone responsible for regulating our body activities. Okay. So that is the speciality of pancreas. What is the speciality of pancreas? It is both exocrine and endocrine. That means it is responsible for producing the digestive juices, responsible for the digestion. At the same time, it is responsible for producing the hormones that able to maintain the body activities. Okay. Then the next we can discuss about the location of the pancreas. Okay. So I think all of you know where does the pancreas is located, because it is the part of the digestive system. So the pancreas is located in between the stomach and the duodenum. Have you heard about duodenum? Duodenum is the first part of small intestine. I already told you, you know, digestive system consists a group of organs and the small intestine is one of the organ. So in between the stomach and the duodenum, where is the position of the pancreas? Okay, and this pancreas is located in between the stomach and duodenum as a leaf-like structure. Suppose this is the stomach. So in between the stomach and duodenum, the presence of pancreas as a leaf-like structure, and this consists a group of cells. These cells are known as islets of Langerhans. Okay, so the position we are discussing about, the position of the pancreas. Pancreas is located in between the stomach and duodenum, and it consists a group of cells. They are known as islet of Langerhans. And this islets of Langerhans again consist of two type of cell. They are alpha cells and beta cells. Alpha cells and beta cells. Okay. And alpha cell is responsible for producing the hormone glucagon. alpha cell is responsible for producing the hormone glucagon and beta cell is responsible for producing the hormone insulin. And by the combined effort of both these hormone, that is glucagon and insulin, what is happening? The normal level of glucose in the human body is maintaining. And do you know what is the normal level of glucose in the human body? Yes, that is 72/110 milligram per 100 ml. That means 100 ml blood contains 72/110 milligram of glucose. And if it is below 70 and if it is above 110, both condition will be harmful to our human body. So if there is a variation, whenever required, the respective gland stimulated and they will produce this hormone, and as a result of their combined effort, the glucose level is normal level of glucose is maintaining in the human body. Okay, so next we can check what will happen when the amount of glucose increases or decreases in the human body. Okay, so let us check what is the possibilities of that. Okay, so first of all, I am going to make a discussion about what will happen when the level of glucose increases in the human body. Suppose the level of glucose, I already told you there is a medium or minimum level, and if any variation happens, that means if there is any excess amount of glucose in the human body, suddenly that information will pass through the nervous system to which gland, you know? To the pancreas. And in pancreas, the beta cells will get stimulated. Okay, which cell? Beta cell will get stimulated, and by the stimulation of the beta cell, it will produce the hormone insulin. And with the production of the insulin, what will happen, you know? The excess amount of glucose will converted into glycogen. I think all of you heard about glycogen. It is a polysaccharide. And it is, what is the speciality, you know? It is insoluble. So the soluble glucose will converted into insoluble glycogen, and this glycogen will get stored in the liver. As a result, what will happen? The level of glucose will be decreases and decreases. Gradually, it becomes the normal level. And until that time, the production of the insulin will be continued. Okay, so that what is happening when the level of glucose increases in the human body. And the next, we can check what will happen when the level of glucose decreases in the human body. In the same way, when there is a decreased amount of glucose in the blood, what will happen? That information will pass through the nervous system. Already we studied in the first chapter, how does it is transmitting? Through the nervous system to the pancreas itself, and in pancreas, the alpha cells, they will get stimulated. And by the stimulation of the alpha cell, which hormone will produce? No, glucagon. Glucagon will produce, and what is the action of glucagon, you know? This glucagon is responsible for converting the stored glycogen into glucose. And as a result, by the action of this hormone glucagon, the stored glycogen will be converted into glucose, and this process will be continued until the level of glucose will be in the normal in the human body. Okay, and this is what happening when the level of glucose decreases in the human body. So again, I am repeating, by the combined effort of both glucagon and insulin, what is happening? The normal level, that is 72/110 milligram per 100 ml, that is happening in the human body. Okay, so normally this is happening. Then maybe due to any malfunctioning of the pancreas, especially the beta cell is responsible for producing the hormone insulin, you know, what will happen? The production of the insulin will be not happen. And during such condition, what will happen, you know? The excess amount of glucose will not converted into glycogen. Instead of that, this glucose will be excreted through urine. And this condition is called as diabetes. Commonly, we are calling diabetes mellitus. Okay? So, this happens due to the deficiency of insulin. So if insulin is not produced in the sufficient amount, normally what is the function of insulin? Conversion of excess glucose into glycogen. Okay, so if the insulin is not produced in the sufficient amount, this excess glucose will be excreted through urine, and that condition commonly we known as diabetes. Okay, and what is the remedial measure for diabetes? You know, that is the administration of insulin hormone. So normally insulin is produced in our body. Due to malfunctioning, if the production is not happened or reduced, we can administrate or we can inject insulin artificially into the human body, and this artificially injected insulin is responsible for converting the stored glucose into glycogen, and that level will be compensated. Okay.